This show contains scenes of violence, coarse language, and mature subject matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
Those arrows were really bugging the hell out of me. I thought I'd step outside the compound to make sure everything was all right. Out there. Show yourself, goddammit.
What if I don't want to show myself? How's that gonna make you feel?
Very, very fucking angry. It's gonna make it worse for you. Now you can make it easier and just show up and we could talk. Well, there you are. Who the fuck are you?
You're pretty dense, aren't you? I did leave you a couple warning signs. But you didn't think too much of it, not did you?
How's that for a fucking warning? Who the fuck are you?
I guess there is a little bit of a bite to your bark. My name is Julia. Julia Riley. Pleased to meet you. Sam.
How do you know my name?
I know a lot of things about you. Like, there's a couple of ponies that aren't very happy with you. Not holding up the end of your bargain.
Who are you working for? Enough with all these fucking information on me. Now who are you working for?
I'm working for myself, Sugar Tits.
Sugar Tits? Well, you got quite the tongue on you, madam.
Enjoying life. It's a beautiful night, isn't it? Look at the stars. There's no need to be pointing that gun at me.
There's no need to be shooting arrows to get my fucking attention either. You know...
It did work, not didn't.
What if you would have missed?
I don't miss. I'll just tell you that right now.
Get inside.
And if I did miss, you'd be dead.
Just get inside. So, shut the fuck up and get inside. And put that thing away. Didn't want to wake the others. Was pretty sure Dylan, Jack, and myself could handle this mysterious lady. So, you say you work for yourself, but you have a radio? I have a hard time believing what you're fucking saying to me. Are you lying? I really do not appreciate liars, and if you were listening, you know what I do to bad people now. You fucking tell me the truth right now. I appreciate when people come clean to me.
I haven't lied to you. One little bit. I have no reason to lie. In fact, that's one of the qualities that people like most about me. I don't generally lie.
Let me take that godforsaken fucking mask off your face. There we go. Now we've got a face. Turn around. Alright, now I want to know what the fuck is your deal. How do you know so much about us and why?
I mean, you guys aren't the most stealthy, most hidden away kinds of people. You know, you're trying to run from those ponies, but you're not doing a very good job, if I can track you. Then again, I don't really think that they're the best of trackers.
What's up with the arrows? What kind of attention you're trying to draw to yourself with me?
I get a lot of fun. There's not much to do at the end of the world now, is there? This is just one way of getting your attention. But you should just be happy that I didn't show up with my other calling card. My cattle, I like to call them. You know those weak ones, the infected, they're a lot of fun, wouldn't you agree? And if I really wanted to harm you, I would have showed up with them. 50, 100, 200 of them, they would have been surrounding that building you were sleeping in.
Still don't understand your attraction towards us, me. I don't fucking know what it is. Something smells fishy. You ain't survived alone.
I'm just having a little bit of fun.
I don't believe you. You're a fucking lying bitch. You're gonna tell me everything right now, or I swear to God, I will start by shooting you in the foot and work my way up.
Oh, you can shoot me in the foot all you want, honey, but I'm not lying to you.
Remember what I said about the monster, Sam?
Yeah, you listen to your friend. You see, I didn't think you had the backbone, but, you know, you did shoot at me out there. So I suppose there is a little bit of bark, as I said, to your bite. I just wonder how much bark there is. Are you gonna fucking shoot me or not? Because I'm telling you the truth.
God damn it. I suppose you could have killed me.
Again, as I said, if I were trying to kill you, I would have showed up with my little pets. They would have surrounded that building over there, and you would have been eaten alive in your sleep.
Put your hands down. Need a moment with my boys, if you don't mind. Go at the gate. Wait for me. I refused to become a leader again, but I felt conflicted, needed their opinions. For the record, I was 2 hairs away from pulling the trigger. What do you boys think we should do? I mean, she could have killed me.
She's fucking weird, Sam.
Yeah, pets.
She's a woman. She's out here alone at the moment, as far as we can tell. Either she's really used to having to bluff, or she can back it up. Either way, I don't see her as a threat yet.
That arrow came fucking close to me.
I don't know. See, just having fun like that doesn't make any sense.
Of course it doesn't. But half the people out here lost their fucking marbles.
I'd say more than half have lost their marbles, to be honest.
I don't know what to
All
think.
All I'm saying is I don't think she should be in the same room as us, if that's what you're asking.
Fuck. I'm tired of taking chances. But she could have killed me. Many times, from what I hear. So, we'll let her in. But keep a very close eye. One side saying yes, and the other side saying no. For now, I'd let her in, and hopefully when the others wake, they can take the lead. I was with a lot of people before. Things went south real quick. And then I vowed I'd stay alone. It's too goddamn hard. That's why I have a hard time believing that you are alone. You have to be with people. Now, who are these people?
Well, they're just a couple of friends I met along the way. They seem like they kind of know what they're doing. They're a little jumpy, though, but they're good people. They've kept me safe enough. Hell, one of my pets got a little too close. Hit me in the back of my head. If it wasn't for them, I probably would have been dead.
Leaving arrows all over the goddamn door, you know, that just sends a whole different fucking message. You are lucky I didn't shoot you, and if you know me well enough, you know I'm right.
It was a gamble. Speaking of the arrows, these aren't something I like to leave lying around too much.
Well, so you were promising me I ain't gonna have no surprise attack from the ponies?
To be honest, I've never met them. I just hear about them. They seem like they're a bunch of idiots. I have watched them have their little firefights from a distance. It's quite entertaining to see them run around like ants.
What about arrows in our backs? Would you be expecting any of those either?
Again, if I was going to kill you, I would have done it.
Maybe you try to gain our trust and then just turn. A lot of people have done that before.
Why the hell would I try and gain your trust? No, I gotta ask you. Why would I try to gain your trust if I was going to kill you? I could have done it hundreds of times. You have nothing to worry about for me.
See anything out there?
Nothing yet. It's been surprisingly quiet for Green Mountain.
That's right. I forgot you guys are familiar with this place. Rhett communicated with me. He should be on his way. Should be the only person you see.
Thanks for the heads up.
Of course.
All I know, every time I've been trailed by someone, and I either didn't notice them, there's something very dark about that, and I notice everybody that follows me. Everyone.
To hear, she seems so happy. Unsettling, to say the least.
Too happy. You're a good man. You don't change a thing, Dylan. You've got a good head on your shoulders.
Thank you, Morgan. I say the same thing to you.
I just listen to him. I'm just a man.
It's about What was her name? Julia. Yeah. There's a major problem. I'm not trying to, you know, say you're wrong or anything like that, but she isn't right. Yeah, it makes any sense.
Sam, let me tell you something. People can change how they act at any time. She's standing there. Sure, she does that. All the rest of us would do something. But if she was alone like this, hell, if I wanted to right now, I could kill you.
But I know you won't.
We don't know her. You didn't know me before, but just a gut feeling right now.
I understand. And I'm not gonna lie, I do too. But one thing's for damn sure. I'm usually pretty damn good at detecting who are good and who are bad. Now, I admit she's fucking weird. That's hands down. However, I'm willing to take a chance just like I did with y'all. But I understand, I'm not the one who calls the shots here. As much as some people seem to want that or stipulate that it is, I am not. I never want to take that responsibility again. So, if y'all decide on something, then that wins over my word. Unless you trust what I say is true, then by all means.
Why don't you allow us to just take her weapons and make sure she won't do anything stupid to us? We're making the first move so that nobody else gets hurt, and that's the safe choice.
I'm not gonna stop you.
She can stay, but no weapons.
And by all means, you were there, you saw me. Fuck's sake, I shot 2 inches away from her head. I came real close to getting rid of the problem, but I took a chance. Now that was me. Now, you all can do what you feel is right. I am not one to stop you. Just like you seem to trust my judgment, usually, I will trust yours. I'll go back inside now. You decide from here on what is best to do. I'm not a leader. Not anymore. For some reason, they still look up to me. Maybe I'm gonna have to slip up sometimes for them to understand I don't want to be responsible for their lives. I'm only here to help and support.
Who we got here?
Right?
Well, look who it is.
Wow.
Man, oh, wow. Hey. You alright?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Everything's okay here. Just glad you got my message. I wasn't getting anything back on radio from you. I was a little worried, so we stayed a little bit longer, waiting for you.
Well, I appreciate that. So, let's see a new face.
I ain't gonna lie, it was nice to see Rhett return to us alive and well. I introduced him to Julia, and then caught him up on the whole situation. But I gotta say, it's been mighty fucking quiet. Apart from Julia, ain't nobody else come across us.
It's been a while since I've been back. I was here, there's a whole bunch of people in this group. I don't know what they're called, but they, came in here and started shooting up the place. A lot of ammunition, a lot of weapons. They got fucking destroyed, and then their screams kinda fucks you up a little bit. Not gonna lie.
You're gonna be okay. You're gonna be alright. Yeah, hello?
Hello?
Hello? Mm-hmm. I see the lights.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi. We need help. Can you guys help us? I see the lights. Oh, whoa.
Who are you?
My name is Jonathan. This is my wife, Vanessa. Don't worry, we're not threats. We've just been running the fucking infected. Please, she's fucked up her hand real fucking bad. I really don't want it to get infected or anything. It's just please, you guys, please help her.
Get
in here.
Yeah, get you cleaned up.
Yeah, sure.
Jesus
Christ. So we can.
Yeah. I killed you.
Keep an eye on them.
Sit down. Give me your hand.
Sure.
Watch your hand, it's okay.
So what happened exactly?
We were dealing with infected. And I got my finger smashed in a door. I think it's broken.
So if I touch that, is that gonna hurt?
Yep,
Yeah, it hurts a little bit.
Yep. Yeah, that
hurts. How the hell would you smash your hand into a door while doing with infected?
They were everywhere. They were fucking coming through the fucking windows. They were fucking everywhere.
Don't inject me with too much of that stuff, yeah?
Nah, I'm just gonna put a little bit. It's gonna numb the finger. It'll be alright.
What was your names again?
Jonathan, hi. Nice to meet you.
Right.
This is Vanessa.
Alright. Well, I need
how about
yourself? What's
your name, stranger?
What in the Lord's name?
Sorry, waking you, Morgan. We have some guests. Jonathan and Vanessa here. Vanessa's badly hurt.
I was gonna make a run to one of the hospitals, but I saw the lights up here, and I was wondering if you guys had, like, a settlement or something up here. Do you guys live in here?
Maybe we're living here. Maybe we're just staying for a night. Maybe you're just lucky you found us.
Really appreciate you helping my wife, though. Is there anything I could do for you? Like, if you need anything, I don't have any medical supplies, or I would have helped her myself, but...
I don't need anything now, thank you.
You should be fine. You should be fine.
No. I mean, it's just me and her. We've been running around. If there was more of us, someone could help us.
Yes.
She, of course.
Why do you wear the masks?
I don't know if, like, these certain people wear them around the area, but it kind of looks intimidating most of the time. Keeps people off of us. I've run into some guys before, and they haven't really messed with us, so I've kind of just kept it working. And if it's worked thus far, I'm going to keep doing it, you know what I mean? I don't see a problem with it.
Morgan, look, I wear a mask. I don't see a problem with you.
I've seen your face before. I don't know these people.
I mean, if it makes you feel better, I mean, I can take it off.
Maybe that could save your life. So yeah, I would like to see your faces.
Yeah,
sure. Ah, man, this is so lucky that we found you guys. Oh,
yeah.
You've been surviving on your own all this time?
Well, we used to have a little crew of people. Oh, God.
What happened?
My friend, Ian, let's just say, ran into some bad people. Some of them got quick deaths. Some of them, not so much. Well, Vanessa and I, we weren't there at the time. Came back to the camp, and... Well, there wasn't much left.
And what about the horsemen? Ever heard of them?
No. Do they hang around in Zelenogorsk and they go on the coast? I've been on the coast a few times. I met a few people down there. There was these cool scientists I met over in town next to that big city on the coast. They seemed alright in my book, but I haven't met anyone named the Horseman.
They hang around an airfield. Might want to stay clear. Bad news.
Alright. They like cannibals too? Like the fucking... those clown guys?
I don't think that's what they do.
We don't usually, honestly, go this... far north, but we need to go find a hospital, and the hospital we searched didn't have anything left. They were completely looted. We're hoping to find some stuff up here.
Well, you all seem all right. I'm not gonna lie, we're gonna keep an eye on you. You're welcome to stay. We're probably gonna leave in the morning. Not sure yet. Now, of course, I would have patched them up to send them on their merry way, but I'm not trying to look like a leader. But the guys were already talking about our new guests. Look, if it counts, they look all right. She was in trouble.
Nobody looks alright, Sam. You can't do that anymore. I could be wearing no clothes and I could look alright to you.
Well, alright. I support you. Do what you gotta do.
Why don't you? If you support me, then you do it.
Anything to eat?
Yeah. That's what we were doing. We were looking for food and we grabbed some. And we were just eating inside one of the houses when they started coming.
Sorry to interrupt. But everybody would feel more at ease if you would hand over the weapons just during your stay.
Please, absolutely. Here, take it.
I felt like I could trust these people, but the others are right. We have to take precaution.
Seem all right. You know, they've been nice to us so far, so...
So, what do you think plans are after this?
I don't know.
Definitely avoid that airfield. I
want to
deal with those guys.
Yeah, definitely.
I think we should stay out of that tire area, honestly. It sounds pretty dangerous to me.
You don't have a sidearm.
Yeah, as you can see, I do not have a sidearm. I wish I did.
You should put one in there. Seems outplaced.
Yeah, if I had a sidearm.
Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. I'm talking to you.
Alright, boss.
Yeah, people who just want to stay safe, pretty heavy kind of rifle you have in there.
That you got there is pretty heavy duty.
If you want my stuff, listen, just let us leave.
I'm not saying I want your stuff, I'm just saying. Are you lying to us?
I mean, if I was lying, yeah, I wouldn't have given you my gun. But, kind of sketching me out, man.
Sketching us out.
Alright, fine. Listen, if you're sketched out, me and her, we get out of here. You guys helped us, you did enough. You've been more than helpful, sir, over there. We'll get out of your hair, I don't want any trouble. Guy seems to really, like, if you want my vest.
I don't want your stuff. I'm just saying. Yeah, you expect me to want something in return for helping out your woman's finger? I mean, I didn't get anything, but I'm not looking for anything.
I'm gonna settle this problem right now. I don't want no stress anymore. And clearly they have something against this couple. So I took initiative. I gave them back their weapons and sent them on their way. I don't want to be a leader, but damn, I'm tired of being stressed.
Sam, was it?
Yes.
Man, you've been a great help, man. You've been a more help than anyone has in a very long time in this shitty fucking world, man. And I appreciate it so much.
Fair enough.
It's been an honor to meet you, and hope we meet in the next life.
It was nice to meet you. Good luck out there. I hope you do well for yourselves. Be careful. Look after your wife. Not everybody has that privilege.
Before we leave, do you have any food or anything?
I thought we were staying the night, so I wasn't hungry now, but who knows about tomorrow. We only managed to scrounge up a bit.
Who's got something? We're not fucking animals.
Yeah, this should get the both of you by. Just fine.
Alright, well, it's been great, honestly.
Sorry it couldn't happen easier, it's...
Put your fucking stop!
What?
All of you, right hands up! Right fucking now,
hands up.
Stupid motherfuckers!
Oh, fuck me!
Okay, fine.
The guys were right. I trust too easily. What have I done?
Let me close this fucking gate. We're gonna be here for a while.
Good.
Everybody in that fucking tower, better fucking come down with your hands raised.
If I find anybody in here without their fucking hands up, you're getting greased, boy.
I didn't see anyone up there.
Anybody's in the fucking tower.
All these fucking idiots. Sure. We're sitting here.
We're all here.
This is everyone. There's no one else.
Do your thing, Austin. We got you back.
Can you hear me? Come on. There's gotta be something in there. Come on.
What's the point of all this?
Got anything to say? What's the point of all this? Listen here, you motherfucker. I'm sorry. Let me introduce myself. I apologize. Hi, my name's Austin Maverick. It's honestly a pleasure to finally meet you. I've heard so much about you. You fucking hick. I've heard that you promised one of my good friends, Charlie, that you were going to get some information for me. How many days have passed? What has it been? Seven?
Almost a week.
Seven fucking days? Almost a fucking week. I thought they gave you 3 days.
I couldn't find anything. Sue me.
Get the other world.
Don't Jesus. Fucking speak to me like that.
Fuck.
No. Please.
What?
No.
You.
Buddy, don't say anything.
I've met you once before.
We had a chance crossing once when I was returning from my good friend. And I found you in the woods. You should have stayed in those woods, buddy. You should have stayed in those woods.
Now you've got yourself mixed up with filth like this, scum.
Oh, fuck you.
Charlie!
Take this motherfucker. Take him inside.
Move. Go.
Man, it would suck to be you, pal.
Teach him to speak better and more polite. Now, the rest of you, you'll learn soon enough that you're not in a position to say anything I don't want you to say. I say jump, you say how high, sir. Makes sense, right?
I said makes sense, right?
Right.
Good. Where's that one fucking piece of shit? There you are. You, step the fuck forwards.
How far?
Fucking, that's exactly what I'm gonna do, you motherfucker!
Ugh. Fuck.
Funny fucking guy.
No, but you told me though.
I gave you a good amount of time to cough up any information.
Yeah. Take 2 steps forward.
How can you even get anything?
I tried, okay?
Listen, you stupid fuck. Smart mouth me again, and I'll make sure you don't smart mouth anyone ever. Does that make sense?
Yep.
I tried, okay?
You didn't try fucking hard enough, but...
Fuck! They're in the west. West of these fucking tents, I don't know, place called Moschino. That's all I fucking know right now. I was about to make my way to them, and you guys fucking arrive.
What do you need from us? We're gonna work it out with you, honestly.
I'll get to that part. No,
get
I like you. You're very nice. Honestly, yeah, no, it's been edited.
Oh, really?
Awesome. Great. Yeah, what's up?
Right. Finally caught something up.
Really? That was quick.
That's the rat.
What did the little rat squeak?
Lady first.
Oh, well, apparently they're in the west of the machine.
Really?
That's it? I gave you 4 extra days, and that's all you found out for me.
He's told you everything he's gonna tell you.
What's your name?
Jack, no.
Jack.
Listen here, Jack.
You're a bystander. You're nothing. You're not even important enough to warrant me hurting you. That's how fucking irrelevant you are to me. If you want to become relevant, keep speaking up, and we'll see what happens. Understood?
Yeah, I can see your pussy mouth flapping. I get you.
Jack, what? Oh,
fuck. Real easy to talk shit when you got guns pointed at everybody, isn't it?
Jack.
Just ignore him.
Oh, yeah, don't worry. I'm just gonna brush it off my shoulder. Look, it's gone.
Doesn't matter.
For him.
Move!
Oh, God.
Stop. Very nice. Now.
I understand you're angry. You got bested. That's fine. I can't let you speak to me like that. You see, this is my first impression on your friends. And honestly, I'm excited. It's great. I love it. These are great people. I can't wait to work with them in the future. And they're going to be very useful to me.
But you, someone like you, you're disposable.